Welcome to Valdosta State University and Whitehead Auditorium. On behalf of the College of the Arts, we are pleased you can join us for this event. A few reminders before we begin. To access the digital program for this event, scan the QR code in the lobby or at the entrance to the hall. Please dim your screen while viewing the program and remember to silence your electronic devices. We ask that you not use your cell phones during the performance as the light is distracting to the patrons sitting around you. The use of cameras or audio and video recording of any kind is strictly prohibited by law without prior permission by the College of the Arts. Food and drinks are not allowed in the auditorium. Out of respect for the performers and those around you, please do not talk during the event, and if you must leave, do so during the pause between pieces or at intermission. Thank you for your attendance and your patronage. Please enjoy the performance, and we hope to see you again soon.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Valdosta State University and the final performances of the South Georgia Region Honor Band. My name is Emily Ann Wynn, and I'm the band director at Hay Hiram Middle School. Seated before you is the Middle School Region Honor Band, and their clinician is Mr. Tyler Grant. Tyler S. Grant is an internationally recognized composer, arranger, conductor, and clinician of music for concert bands, orchestras, and chamber ensembles of all levels. His music is featured regularly in performances by both region and all-state honor ensembles, and is also featured annually on editors' or publishers' choice repertoire lists around the world. It has been such a joy to have Mr. Grant here with our students this weekend, and we are so thankful for his work here at the South Georgia Region Honor Band. Please help me in recognizing the South Georgia Middle School Region Honor Band and their clinician, Mr. Tyler Grant.
Thank you. What an absolute blast it has been to be here down in Valdosta for the past couple days working with these incredible students. Don't they sound amazing? So proud of all the work that they've done to get to this point and to put on this wonderful concert for you. Could not be more proud of them. This next piece is Creed by William Himes. Now, here's the thing. Many of us know back home that our band programs may participate in something called large group performance assessment or evaluation. And so this next piece is actually a piece that most students at this level will spend 6 to 8 weeks on in order to get ready for a performance. And these students put it together just in about basically 2 days. And so it just highlights their amazing skill and their really hard work. It's going to feature several different sections throughout the group, as well as a little trio, a trumpet trio. And it's just a really lovely piece. And so we hope you enjoy William Himes' Creed.
Thank you.
That's been a fun piece to rehearse because many of the band directors in the region played that piece when they themselves were a middle school student or even in high school. And there may even be some band parents out there who performed that too when you were younger. So it's been a really fun one for us to work on. This next piece is probably a piece you've never heard of. It's by a Japanese-American composer, Yukiko Nishimura. Yukiko moved from Japan to the United States, currently lives in the Los Angeles area. And this originally was written for orchestra and was rescored for wind band. And so one of the joys of this weekend has been playing music in a variety of different styles. So this next piece is completely different than both of the first two pieces you just heard, and it's really allowed us to work on more lyrical playing. So we hope you enjoy Yukiko Nishimura's Ancient Flower.
Thank you.
Mr. Grant, if you could join me at the podium. On behalf of the South Georgia Region Honor Band, thank you so much for coming to work with our students. Thank you for sharing your time and your passion for music and for music education with us this weekend. Thank you.
I'll use this microphone this time. It really has been really special to be here in Valdosta and working with these incredible, incredible students. I know that I'm sure there's some moms and dads and parents and family members. If you're a parent of one of these students, could you please stand so we can say thank you to you?
Yes, sir.
Please come on, stand up. There you go. I'm sure these kids are starving, and after this concert, I'm sure they would love to go stop somewhere maybe for ice cream afterwards. Does that sound good? Yeah. Parents, this does not happen without you for driving them all over the place, for supporting your band program back home. Events like this don't happen. Band programs don't exist without parent support. And so no doubt that your children are in the best possible hands with the teachers here in this region. These honor bands don't happen, they don't sound this good, and we don't have this much fun unless there's literally years of wonderful training happening in the band room before they come to this weekend. And so this is just an example of the wonderful teaching that's happening and that your children are experiencing every single day. Please don't let this event, this activity that we do, be something that only you know about. Please tell your friends, please tell your community members, your principals, your administrators, everybody in your community, because it's really a special thing. Your children are not just learning how to play an instrument and how to hold a piece of plumbing or a drum, and they are learning how to be better people. I told them today that could you imagine anywhere in our world right now where you could get 100 strangers together and have them cooperate like this for 2 days? It doesn't happen, right? And some of us can't even do that at Thanksgiving sometimes. So it's really something special, and while many of these students may continue in band and become musicians or even music educators or professional musicians, no matter what profession in our world they become, doctor or a lawyer or a teacher or a coach, no matter what they do, they're a better person for being in their band room in school. They're a better human being, they're a better person in society, and so continue to support your amazing band directors. Could the directors of these students please stand so we can give you a big thank you as well. It takes a lot of extra effort to make this happen. Lastly, I want to thank Dr. Benjamin Harper for the invitation to come and work with these incredible students. This has hardly been work. This has been so much fun. We just have had an absolute blast, and I think these students have had a blast as well. We are going to close with an original composition of mine. I told them what makes me different than most other composers is that I'm not dead yet. And so they had the pleasure of getting to work on a piece that I wrote for the Nebraska Junior High All-State Band a few years ago, and it's called Breakthrough. The piece is supposed to celebrate sweat and drive and determination and the hard work that it takes to achieve something. Yes, talent will get you far, but it doesn't get you all the way. And so very appropriate for the hard work that these students have done this weekend and this amazing school year. So thank you so much for having me, everybody here in this wonderful region. And one more round of applause for these incredible students.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. My name is Jay Davis. I'm the director of bands at Houston County High School in Warner Robins, and it is my pleasure to introduce our clinician for the 910 South Georgia Region Band. Jeffrey Rouser is a 2023 inductee into the National High School Band Directors Hall of Fame. Following a 42-year teaching career with many distinctions, he has received the John Philip Sousa Legion of Honor, GMEA's Distinguished Service Award, and in 2018, he was the Outstanding Alumni Educator of Auburn University. He's been Teacher of the Year numerous times, Star Teacher, and has founded and taught many fine leadership groups across the state and the country. He is truly one of the best band directors to ever have taught in Georgia. I consider myself lucky to have been able to student teach with him and consider him a friend and mentor. You are in for a great concert today. Please help me welcome Mr. Jeffrey Rouser.
That was fun. What a great week it's been, weekend, and what fun we have had. To the parents of the kids on this stage, on your way home, I want you to find out from them. Say, hey, what did you hear or talk about other than music? They should be able to share a lot. This is the background of a high school band, the 9th and 10th graders. They're the ones that will lead the future of the band while the juniors and seniors deal with the rigorous academic world, getting ready to move on.
These are the backbone of leaders. These are the ones that are going to keep the band directors alive for a couple of more years. And so that's a good thing. The next piece I'd like to do for you is entitled Dreams for All of Us. The composer is Heather Hopeful, and she is actually watching, I hope, as she said she would, on the live stream that has taken place. Heather's a fantastic music composer and one of the last few composers hired by Robert W. Smith, one of our great music educators, one of the great family men, one of the great people of the earth, Robert W. Smith. He was able to hire her to be a part of his composing family. I met Heather when she was doing a residency with my middle school band, and had a chance to meet her at that time, and she was not with a publishing company. Her goal was to get with the publishing company, and I was able to speak on her behalf and write a letter on her behalf, along with many others, of her quality work. She was accepted into the fold of the Robert W. Smith Consortium of Composers, and with his passing back in September, I believe it was painful for a lot of us. We were all shocked in the music education world. Heather was writing a piece of music, and it was in honor of Robert W. Smith. As she was writing it, she was trying to figure out the title, and she thought of something that was part of a speech or presentation of a meeting that Robert W. Smith had with many of his composers, talking about dreams for all of their composers to have a place to distribute and house and get their music out to people. And that was able to happen. So that was a part of that dream. And that's how the title came to be, Dreams for All of Us. And so I hope you'll enjoy this. It's not a hard piece of music, but it is a great piece. How many kids here or here have played a Robert W. Smith song? It's hard to go through band and not play the music of one of the masters of our lifetime. Really, really fine music. This piece here starts, you can hear the lamenting and the grieving at the very, very beginning. Then it gets very, very powerful and change tempos as we go through. And I know Heather's watching, so Heather, what I did was, instead of playing the last note as a stinger, I decided to make it a fermata because I really like the closing chord. So I changed that. So everybody, enjoy Dreams for All of Us by the composer Heather Archer Hopeful.
Thank you.
favorite band pieces to teach, especially for an honor band. I always look at what's been played a few years before I get to come, and I realize they had not played this one before, and I say, yes, this is one I absolutely love. It's three movements, and you're going to hear a little bit of a Western feel. You're going to hear a little bit of one of the themes you should recognize, Shenandoah. It's right in the middle, very pretty, and I hope you'll enjoy it. It's kind of like a three-movement work, all in one piece. Enjoy. For the band directors, this is on the level 4 list in our GMEA, American River Song.
Thank you.
Mr. Auser, would you join me over here at the podium, please? How about another hand for this amazing ensemble? I'll take a moment to present you with this. It's a plaque, but just thank you so much for the work you've done with these kids this weekend. With deep gratitude and appreciation to Jeffrey Rouser, conductor 910 Honor Band, for sharing his musical artistry and teaching expertise with our students, South Georgia Region Honor Band, April 13th, 2024. How about a hand for Mr. Rouser? Thank you.
Just so you know, the older you get in this profession, to remain relevant, a day like this means a lot to me. You know, there's a generation gap between me, the directors, and the students with the number of years I've taught. But to be able to come and work with these caliber of students with the top level teaching that's going on in South Georgia, it means a lot to me. I started my career in 1981 in Albany, Georgia, teaching at Radium Springs Junior High. Then I went to Daugherty High School. I was in South Georgia 6 years before I moved up north. So my roots started here in the South. And when I get a chance to come back and do that, I love to tell stories, and the kids can tell you a whole bunch of things that I shared with them in rehearsal. But one of the things I did find out from the kids, they are very serious about how they contribute to music. They're very particular on doing things right. This is a great group of kids, and we talked about leadership, of what that looks like and what it means. And to parents, this is what I want you to find out. If your kid is on a stage right now, if they're planning to try out an audition for leadership in their band, you need to make sure you have a conversation with them about what that is, because it's not about being popular, being cool. It's about doing work in the name of the band director. It's not a power thing to be a boss. It's about service. And that's what leadership is. And we talked about what to do. And I also told them, leadership is not what you put in your essay or what you say in that interview. It's your day-to-day actions of what people see. Because what you give away without words is who you really are. And so we talked about that, and the kids have been phenomenal with asking questions and sharing ideas. We're gonna close this program with a piece called Con by Julie Giroux. This is a level 6 piece in Georgia. And yes, I was a little crazy for picking it, but I liked it. And that's how it all starts, like dessert. I love German chocolate cake and banana pudding. And so that's how I decided to do this. I like this piece of music. So we're gonna give it our very best shot. And the kids came to me and said, Mr. Rouser, this is the hardest piece I have ever played in my musical career. I said, well, great. I'm glad I could contribute that thought in your life. So the next piece we have, it's got a lot of great solo work, a lot of technical passages, and great percussion, and really a fun, fun piece. Thank you to the people of South Georgia Region area to allow me to come, and Dr. Harper, who gave me the call to be able to be a part of this. It really means a lot to me at this point in my career to still have an opportunity to come and work with students and be a part of an honor situation. I do represent AARP very well. And on behalf of all those people that have that club card with me, more power to us.
Good afternoon. My name is Chandler Sumner, and I'm the Associate Director of Bands at Lowndes High School here in Valdosta, Georgia. And it is my honor to introduce the 11th and 12th grade symphonic band and their clinician, Dr. Chad Simons. Dr. Simons serves as the Senior Conductor of Instrumental Music at the University of New Mexico. For 17 years, he has conducted the UNM Symphonic Band, directed all facets of the UNM Athletic Band Program, and serves as the Associate Conductor of the UNM Wind Symphony. We are extremely lucky to have him, as he has been doing some amazing work with our students. Please help me in welcoming to the stage the 11th and 12th grade South Georgia Region Honor Band and their conductor, Dr. Simons.
The housekeeper on the Brady Bunch. we're about to play was written by Frank about 25 years ago in memoriam and dedicated to and for the people of Columbine High School. Those of you who were around then might remember that we consider that to be one of the first mass shootings we had in a public institution. Unfortunately, it wasn't the last. Happens consistently. I don't like this piece. something from my neck of the woods.
Thank you.
you'll join me over here at the podium, please. On behalf of the South Georgia Region Honor Band, we'd like to present you with this plaque to say thank you for all the teaching and growing you've done with our students. Thank you so much. So, once again, your children have been fantastic. Thank you so much for having me back to Georgia. I love coming here because, and I learned this word, y'all have this stuff that shoots out of the ground. It's all green and grows really tall. We don't have that in Albuquerque. Short stuff, brown mostly. These kids have been amazing. We've had such a great time. Will you do this one last little thing for me here? All the directors in the room, this doesn't happen without you. I just couldn't have more respect for the teaching that's going on and for the commitment that it takes to have these kids put in this position. So once again, my buddy Ben Harper, love you, man. Thanks for having me out. And to all the teachers who have done such a great job with these students, thank you. And parents, thank you as well. I will simply end with mucho gusto and gracias. And a heartfelt adios.